Hello, I'm Maruk Saeed, your microbiology guide. Let's explore in-depth micro techniques and uncover groundbreaking insight together on this educational journey into the fascinating realms of microbes.
Salt tolerance test in microbiology. Principle, procedure, results, and applications. Table of contents. Introduction. Objectives. Principle. Requirements. Procedure. Result and interpretation. Quality control. Precautions. Applications. Limitations. Introduction to salt tolerance. Salt tolerance test is a biochemical test used to evaluate the ability of bacteria to tolerate high salt concentrations, 6.5%. Growth requirements vary among bacterial genera, including temperature, pH, water activity, nutritional needs, and salinity. Sodium ions are essential for all organisms, but the required amount and salt tolerance levels differ by species. Halotolerant bacteria or halophiles can tolerate high salt levels, equivalent to or exceeding seawater concentration. Non-halophiles thrive in salt concentrations below 1.7%. Slight halophiles require sodium chloride concentrations between 1.7% and 4.8%. Moderate halophiles require sodium chloride concentrations between 4.8% and 20%. Extreme halophiles thrive at sodium chloride concentrations between 20% and 30%. Halotolerant bacteria are non-halophiles that can tolerate up to 2.5 molar salt concentration. Salt tolerance tests are used in clinical and research laboratories for bacterial identification. These tests differentiate bacterial species based on their salt tolerance levels. Salt tolerance tests help identify halotolerant bacteria, halophiles, and extremophiles. The 6.5% salt tolerance test differentiates Enterococcus species from other gamma-hemolytic, non-hemolytic, Streptococcus species in clinical labs. It aids in bacterial identification and characterization, including differentiation of Mycobacterium species, study of actinobacteria, research on extremophiles, and characterization of Vibrio species. The 6.5% salt tolerance test is widely used in diagnostic laboratories and plays a critical role in understanding bacterial adaptations to high salinity environments. If you have watched till here, don't forget to subscribe to Family of Science Lovers. Press the bell icon button so you are always updated. Objectives. To assess the capability of bacteria to withstand a high salt concentration, 6.5%. Principle of salt tolerance test. Adding salt to a culture medium increases its ionic concentration, which impacts osmotic pressure and membrane permeability across bacterial cell membranes. This makes salt a selective agent, allowing only salt-tolerant or halophilic organisms to grow. Salt-tolerant, halophilic bacteria have evolved specific mechanisms to adapt and thrive in high-salt environments, including increasing cytoplasmic ion concentration to match the external environment, accumulating compatible solutes, e.g., solutes like potassium ions that mimic sodium ions, modifying intracellular water movement processes, altering nucleotides and proteins to maintain functionality in high salt conditions. These adaptations enable salt-tolerant bacteria to survive in 6.5% salt concentration. In contrast, non-halophilic bacteria lack these mechanisms and are susceptible to osmotic shock, plasmolysis, and specific ion effects, leading to their inhibition or death in high salt environments. Requirements for salt tolerance test. Culture media. Modified salt broth containing 6.5% sodium chloride is commonly used for the 6.5% salt concentration test. Brain heart infusion, broth supplemented with 6.5% sodium chloride and 0.1% bromocresol, purple indicator, modified BHI broth, is also widely utilized. Alternatively, tryptic soy broth with 6.5% sodium chloride and 0.1% bromocresol purple indicator can serve the same purpose. Composition of modified salt broth per 1,000 milliliters, HMH peptone, heart digest, 10 gram, peptone, Z-scrammy, glucose, dextrose, 1 gram, sodium chloride, 65 gram, bromocresol purple, 0.01, 6 gram, final pH, 7.2 plus or minus 0.2 at 25 degrees Celsius. Preparation of modified salt broth. Weigh the required amount of modified salt broth powder, 8.6 grams for 100 milliliters water, or individual components. Mix with the required volume of water in a conical flask or glass bottle. Stir well manually or using a magnetic stirrer and heat until all components dissolve. Dispense 5 milliliters, or desired volume, of the broth into test tubes. Cap loosely, or use a cotton plug. Autoclave at 121 degrees Celsius and 15 pounds pressure for 15 minutes. Allow the broth to cool to 40 to 45 degrees Celsius before inoculation. Composition of HI broth per 1,000 milliliters. Calf brain infusion, HM infusion powder, 12.50 gram, BHI powder, 5 gram, protease, peptone, DSET gram, glucose, dextrose, 2 grams, disodium, hydrogen, phosphate, 2.50 gram, sodium chloride, 5 gram, final pH, 7.4 plus or minus 0.2 at 25 degrees Celsius. Preparation of modified BHI broth. Measure BHI broth powder, 37 grams per 1,000 milliliters, along with 60 grams sodium chloride and 0.016 grams bromocresol purple. Add the mixture to 1,000 milliliters of water in a conical flask or glass bottle. Stir and heat until all components dissolve completely. Dispense 5 milliliters, or desired volume, into test tubes, leaving caps loose or using cotton plugs. Autoclave at 121 degrees Celsius and 15 pounds pressure for 15 minutes. Cool to 40 to 45 degrees Celsius before inoculation. Reagents: sodium chloride, extra pure or laboratory grade, bromocresol purple indicator, equipment test tubes, incubator, weighing machine, autoclave, Bunsen burner, inoculating loop, personal protective equipment, PPE, and general laboratory materials. Test organisms, sample bacteria, positive control, Enterococcus faecalis, ATCC29212, negative control, Streptococcus bovis, ATCC33317. Procedure of salt tolerance test. Using a sterile inoculating loop, collect well-isolated colonies of the sample bacteria from a fresh culture, 18 to 24 hours old. Transfer 1 to 2 loops of bacterial suspension or fresh broth culture into the test broth. Incubate the inoculated tubes aerobically at 35 degrees Celsius, plus or minus 2 degrees Celsius for 24 hours. Observe the tubes for visible growth turbidity or a change in color. If no growth is observed, continue incubating the tubes. Check for turbidity or color change at 48 and 72 hours. Result and interpretation of salt tolerance test. Positive result: bacterial growth, indicated by increased turbidity and or a color change in the broth from purple to yellow. Typically observed within 24 hours, but may take up to 48 to 72 hours for certain Enterococci strains and up to 14 days for Mycobacterium species and Actinobacteria. Negative result: No bacterial growth, no turbidity, and no color change in the medium. Quality control. Enterococcus faecalis, ATCC 29212, exhibits increased turbidity and a yellow color change in the medium after 24 hours of incubation. Streptococcus bovis, ATCC 33317, shows neither growth nor any color change, even after 72 hours of incubation. Common salt-tolerant pathogenic coccibacteria. Enterococcus species, Staphylococcus aureus, Streptococcus agalactiae. Precautions. When adding salt to the ready-made culture medium, consider the amount of sodium chloride already in the medium and adjust accordingly to achieve a final sodium chloride concentration of 6.5%. Do not report negative results at 24 hours. Re-incubate for up to 72 hours before concluding negative results. Use a light inoculum, as a heavy inoculum can cause turbidity, leading to a false positive result. Applications of salt tolerance test. Distinguishing Enterococcus species from other non-hemolytic streptococci, group D streptococci, non-enterococci. Differentiating Aerococcus species, salt tolerant at 6.5%, from other similar cocci, such as Stomatococcus and Helicoccus, both non-salt tolerant. Limitations of salt tolerance test. It is not a definitive test and should be complemented with other biochemical tests for accurate bacterial genus and species identification. Certain beta-hemolytic streptococci, e.g., Streptococcus agalactiae, may also grow in 6.5% NaCl, potentially leading to confusion in identifying enterococci. Minimal growth without acid production can complicate the interpretation of turbidity. If bacteria grow without producing acid, the medium's color remains unchanged, making it challenging to interpret results. A minimum of 72 hours is required before reporting a negative result. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, press the bell icon button. Thank you!